It is indeed my pleasure to welcome all of you to this discussion, hopefully very interactive and hot discussion on the union budget. It is my special privilege to welcome an old friend, Mr. Chengal Reddy, Chairman Cooperative of Indian Farmers Association, to this event. Shri M. Venkateshwarlu, President TECCI, and our colleagues from PwC, Amit Mishra and Rajita Burgu, directors at PwC, Mr. Hanumanlu, Chartered Accountant, and all of you here. Just give a small briefing on the budget. We have to understand the backdrop in which this budget was presented. First of all, let me be very clear from the industry perspective. Because it was after the GST, the expectations for budget were very low. And a day before, when somebody asked me, what do you expect from the budget? I said, if there is no negative, it will be a great positive. Because I was very clear that the budget will definitely have something negative for the industry and the big business, so that the next day the page is splashed, as my friend was saying, that everything is bad for the industry and they're doing for other sectors, for the poorer sections of the society. So there is an optical illusion which needed to be put in the budget, and therefore the expectations were very, very low. Secondly, there was a huge amount of farm tristesse which was going around all over the country, and this was expected to be addressed in the budget. So this was the backdrop in which the budget was there. So it had to be a negative for the industry. So let us, before I look at what are the cons of the budget, the problems in the budget, let us look at where we can give credit to the finance minister. First of all, after a long time, we have seen a finance minister who is happy with 11 months revenue of the GST. He did not try to squeeze money. We have been so used to being squeezed by the finance minister in the last quarter, making us pay taxes which were not due. So here is the finance minister who is not even considering the taxes due in the year and taking it to the next year. So that's a great credit. 250 crores and below, the taxes have been reduced, so I think we should give him credit. No major freebies. So close to an election where you don't give away something free, is a great achievement of any political institution. And I think the biggest thing which is there in this budget is a very, very ambitious health program. We don't know how this will actually play out. But if I look at the growth story of India and the demographic dividend which the Indian public should have, the only thing which can hold us back from a great demographic dividend is health. And any expenditure on health, because of this one reason, is more than welcome. The point is, we have to see how this will actually play out. Now let us look at the negatives. I was just having a discussion. High expenditure on health and on agriculture and infrastructure is very much required. But if you look at the inflation impact of that, it could be a little more, and the inflation could impact interest and therefore impact industry. So that is one worry which we have. Already the bond markets have taken it on a chin. The finance minister had promised that the taxes will come down. So at least the least which was expected was the direction will be towards reduction. But if you look at the large houses, the tax has actually gone up. So this is a very clear betrayal as far as the large taxpayers are concerned. One thing which I felt really strongly about was, in the last 3-4 years, for the first time in many, probably a century, we had a shift of savings from non-productive assets, that is gold and land, towards productive assets, financial assets, equity and other things. The impact of LTCG, whether it is fair or not, is another story. But the point that it has created a break to this move from productive assets to a non-productive assets is something which I am really upset about. Just to end, on a slightly lighter vein, one day before the budget, we had a triple event. We had an event when we had a full moon. The full moon was a blue moon, and the blue moon was an eclipse. So we had a triple agent event. So it was very clear that the next day also had to be a triple event. And the triple event had to happen in the form of the budget. On top of that, you had a situation where BJP lost 3 elections in Rajasthan. And on top of that, we have had the highest ever fall in the US stock market. So this triple event all over the world had to have the impact which has. It has had. I look forward to a very, very productive discussion. And I especially once again welcome Mr. Chengal Reddy. In this time when we are talking so much about the farm sector and we understand so little of the farm sector, it is a very welcome thing that Mr. Chengal Reddy is here so that a lot of myths in our minds can be dispelled. Once again, welcome all of you.